So one of the hallmarks of Samaritan Daytop Village is we look at each individual from their perspective and tailor each of our services to that person. It's hard to do when you're serving 33,000 people each and every year. And our staff, they rise to that challenge every day, and they really do individual services for 33,000 people a year. So Jerry Heaney, who's our Vice President of Transitional Housing, oversees all of our shelters. It's a very large part of what we do. You know, he's also been very upfront about his personal story.
So Jerry, this is our 60th anniversary year, but just a week ago, you celebrated 30 years
yes.
with Samaritan Daytop Village, which yes. is incredible.
I needed some guidance and direction, and the agency definitely gave it to me, and then some. It sounds kind of odd to say, but fell in love with the ability to have an opportunity to get a job in a place that saved my life. And now in the job of vice president, I have actually 650 staff with about 5,000 clients on a daily basis. Sometimes I have to remind myself, you know, the kind of impact that I've been able to make. Even with the newer staff that come in, when I tell them about our timeline and where we've started, and I've been a part of that for 30 years, it's exciting to do that.
Samaritan Daytop Village started 60 years ago. Father Picatley was the de facto founder. A lot of it then was being in the courthouses, helping people who had addictions. So to fast forwarding a little, Richard Press became our leader and really a vision of, you know, expanding that and integrating it with other services. And then my immediate predecessor, Tino Hernandez, a true visionary who, you know, understood the value of integrating those services even more in a single location. Samaritan Daytop Village has grown exponentially over the last really decade, and a lot of that growth was due to mergers, one of them Daytop. One of the great things about that merger was that we got a lot of tremendous talent, none more so than Alicia McFarlane.
What makes me get out of bed every day is knowing that at work, in some small way, I'm able to give back to someone, possibly give them hope to continue another day. Working in criminal justice, we all see the revolving door, and the goal of the service is to figure out how to break that cycle, how to treat the clients and place them in situations where they can be empowered to do better. Programs like Samaritan Daytop Village do that every day.
Mental health issues and addiction and health issues and homelessness. Looking to the future, we want to integrate all those services. We're excited that in 2021, we're going to be opening the Richard Press Wellness Center, where almost all those services will be in one location. So the hallmark of Samaritan Daytop Village for 60 years has been its staff. We've overcome challenges every decade of those 60 years, but none more challenging than the pandemic. Our staff were heroes. It was just incredible that our staff came into their jobs each and every day, and I and all the rest of the executive staff and our boards are eternally grateful to them, and so are our clients.